I've heard it said that motivation is generated in two ways. We are either running away from something we don't want or running towards something we do want. The media is very good at highlighting the horrors of a high sugar diet that we want to avoid. The challenge with these fear-filled headlines is that they cause us to feel anxious, which can easily push us into the comforting arms of sugary treats like cookies, cakes, and candies. In this video, we will take the road less traveled and discuss why a sugar-free life is a wonderful thing, and I'll be using the words of viewers just like you to prove it. Are there actually people out there happily living life without sugar? The answer is yes, but if you feel as if you are being held captive by sugar, you might think they are lying or write them off as just one of those people. The reality is that life is good on the other side of sugar, and many people have successfully kicked sugar, but I don't want you to take my word for it. I've collected comments from viewers who have kicked the habit. My hope is that this video moves you from a place of no way I can give up sugar to it must be possible, or even I'm going to do it. Let's start with some social proof that giving up sugar is possible. Kay wrote, "No sugar 100 days today. I feel great. I've lost 20 plus pounds and my arthritis thanks me. Once you go just a few days, the sugar cravings dissipate. Today, I am not even the slightest bit tempted. I've taken my life back and clean eating is here to stay." JC added this comment, "March 12th will be my 2-year anniversary of being sugar-free. I ransacked my house and got rid of everything. The key is you have to allow time to pass for your palate to change." One common thread that you'll notice as we move through these comments is that once you stop eating sugar, cravings diminish and your taste for sugar changes. JC went on to write, "I went to my mother's house for Christmas. It was my first Christmas sugar-free, so I was slightly concerned, but I kept telling myself I had made it this far, so I must keep pressing on." Now, she made my favorite cookies, and she's 80 years old. I didn't want to hurt her feelings, so I told her I would sample them, which meant one bite, and let her know how they came out. These were my favorite cookies. I used to bang down 3 or 4 with a cup of coffee with no problem. I took one bite and the sweetness just locked me up, lol. I couldn't eat anymore, neither did I have the desire to. It didn't taste the same. It was way too sweet, and amazingly enough, I didn't like it anymore. That's when you know you've turned the corner. This newfound experience that sugary treats become too sweet to be enjoyable is a common theme. Baby A had this experience. "I gave up processed foods and sugar. Fruit is the only thing that satisfies my sweet tooth when I want a little something sweet, where candy, chocolate, and cake are now too sweet for me to eat and actually make me nauseous. Never thought that would ever happen, but it did." There are physiological changes that happen inside of you that explain why avoiding sugar makes sugar cravings go away and causes you to lose your taste for sweets. When we frequently give in to the desire to give ourselves a sugar fix, we see things happen in an area of the brain known as the nucleus accumbens that make our sugar cravings even stronger. Eating sugar multiple times a day chronically stimulates this area of the brain, causing it to downregulate or become less sensitive to sugar. The result is that you need more sugar to get the same sugar high that you used to get. In other words, you crave more of it. When you stop eating sugar, this process reverses, and the next time you eat sugar, it tastes intensely or even uncomfortably sweet. Also, a study published in the American Journal of Clinical Nutrition found that after just 1 month of a low sugar diet, your taste buds become more sensitive to sugar. This sets you up for success because less sugar is now more enjoyable and too much sugar is unpleasant. So all you have to do to stop eating sugar is stop eating sugar. Yeah, I get it. That's easier said than done. The reality is that sugar is an addictive substance. When you stop taking it in, you can expect a period of withdrawal symptoms. Faye wrote, "I dropped sugar completely 3 months ago. The first week was a bit hard. I was craving it. I was a tad cranky and was tired in the afternoon. But for me, when I got past that period, everything changed. My energy soared, my cravings went away. Even today, 3 months later, I have no desire for a cookie or cake or dessert. I can serve it to others as I did this weekend when we had guests and watch them eat, and I do not feel a craving. Leslie added, "Hi, Dr. Becky. I'm 3 weeks into not using sugar. It's hard, but I'm getting through it. I'm so proud of myself because I thought it would be so hard to do, but not having it in your home helps you to stay disciplined so you can remain motivated in your mindset. Thanks so much for these great tips. They are extremely helpful." There is no way around the fact that you will need to stop eating sugar to reach a place of comfort. You might find it helpful to reframe this movement away from sugar as an experiment, like the one Raging historically mentioned. My mother and sister drank tea constantly, always with 2 teaspoons of sugar. They were advised to continue drinking tea without sugar for 2 weeks. They were warned they would find it disgusting, but they were persistent, after which they could return to sugary tea. They did it despite hating the unsweetened tea. After 2 weeks, they made tea with sugar and could not believe how disgusting it was. They have never taken sugar in their tea since. That was 30 years ago. I am going to say that the bodies of this mother and daughter team were very happy that they weathered that 2 week period 30 years ago. I encourage you to do like these ladies and perform a 2 week sugar-free experiment. But keep in mind that you will have some challenging days and you'll need to remain vigilant after the period to avoid stepping back into your old habit. For instance, DB wrote, "Once I get through the first 2 weeks without sugar, I'm free of cravings. But if I have just one treat after that, I have opened a door that is hard to shut again." So consistent effort is required, but the benefits will be worthwhile regardless of your age. DB went on to write, "My son had become overweight and was having behavioral issues when he was 10 years old. We stopped feeding him sugar and white flour, and he returned to a normal weight in 3 months. The behavior changed virtually overnight." Betsy Keto shared that the decision to go without sugar for whatever period of time one chooses to do so is, of course, an individual one. "I will tell you that I tried for over 60 years to include it in my life in manageable amounts, but was never able to successfully do so. It always led me back to substantial weight gain and a multiple of other health issues. Giving up sugar was one of the best decisions I ever made and has given me a freedom I've never known. It changed my life for the better. I only wish I had done it sooner. Your journey may be different." It is a wonderful thing to experience freedom from sugar cravings. Sugar can hijack your thoughts, making it hard to stay mentally sharp. But breaking away from sugar is not just freeing for your mind, it is also freeing for your body. Doug ZD wrote, "Almost 4 years now without excessive sugar or carbs and dropped 6 inches off my waist without even trying. Now that alone has made it worth it for me." Debbie shared, "I quit sugar and my fasting glucose went from 101 pre-diabetes down to 90 normal range." The 5-Minute Body wrote, "I have ditched the sugar for 5 years. Nothing sweet at all. I've lost 26 pounds, reversed my PCOS, and actually never hungry. Sugar is a drug. You need to quit it." And Fifth Dimension added, "I gave up all sugar and flour in August and have lost 35 pounds. I've also lost irritable mood swings and daily emotional beatings for eating crap all day long. While I mourn some sweets, it doesn't outweigh how grateful I am for feeling good throughout the day. I wish the same for you in 2022. You may have picked up on the fact that some of the commenters have been sugar-free for years. Some of you will find that inspiring, while others will find it intimidating, with the fear being that sugar-free is an all or nothing proposition. So, if you take the steps to give up sugar, does that mean you can never again eat a piece of birthday cake? The reality is that every person is different. Some people are more susceptible to the pull of sugar than others. that susceptibility is hard to predict because it is based on physical as well as emotional factors, from fond childhood memories to stress relief to just wanting a moment to be carefree. What you'll find is that with time away from sugar, the changes in brain chemistry and taste buds break the physical desire for sugar, making it easier to manage these emotional ties. When that happens, many people find that they can have an occasional treat without backsliding into cravings. Deb shared, "I have cheat days on birthday, holidays, and special occasions, but much less in portion. I have a greater love of fruit now and do have better skin and less gastric issues now. I lost 28 since September from lessening sugar a lot and carbs, but stay 50 to 80 grams and sometimes 130 on high-end days and lower on salad intermittent fasting days. I'm 62. You can do it." So there you have it. There used to be a saying, a moment on the lips, a lifetime on the hips. The moment is fun, but there is a lot more long-term enjoyment out there. As Privet Prince put it, life is excellent without sugar. If you would like some guidance, I encourage you to download my 0123 strategy. It has been downloaded by more than 90,000 people. It comes with a free video series that helps you get the most out of the strategy so you can confidently move toward an enjoyable sugar-free life. You can get all of these materials on my website, drbeckyfitness.com/free. Please subscribe to my channel before you go and share this video if you found it helpful. Thanks for watching. Have a great rest of your day.